What's going on, guys, and welcome back to the channel. We are here once again with some more joy of life. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the reactions, man. This story just took a wild turn in episode 13. I'm looking forward to seeing what's going to happen in episode 14, as we are going to do today. Kind of teared up there a little bit for Tang, man. Tang, he was a day one. He was a day one friend, man. Those are the types of friends that you can't just find by, you know, meeting someone on the street. You know what I mean? Like, those type of friends are just like, it's a development, man. It's a overtime situation, man. I really like the dude too, man. He's one of my favorite characters in the show. You know, and to see him go out like that, go out fighting, it was well done. We will miss him. Anyways, let's jump into the reaction, and I will see you guys at the end for the review.
有人劝我在无人处杀你，我不乐意。你当街出手，暴虐残杀罪无可恕，我就是要当着大庭广众的面杀你。有人要跟你做交易，我不做。大局不能杀你，我来杀。你拖住范闲，跟我走。走。上次一战，我真气又有精进，今日你必死无疑。快叫人阻止范闲！
在这个世界上，如果没有让你甘愿去死的人，那活着多没意思。我明白，有了这样的人，在这个世界才算扎下了根。
就在当街，
是按照您的吩咐，一处的枪手坐在城外的小树林里埋伏应变。
行了，我亲自去。
They're going personally. Damn, he just one hit him. Damn, that's all it took.
This is 藤子京的刀。你应该记住这名字。
Damn.
等会儿疼。我还在找你呢。你不就在箱子里了？
你过来，
范叔叔。
别动手！
你头怎么了？
你别伤害他，我可以放你走。脸转过去。
你和箱子里的大块头认识吗？
你刚才挟持的做人质，或许还有机会。
我出生以来，见我面者有恐惧，有厌恶，要么求我杀人。退避三舍，请我吃果子的只有他一个。
对啊，他吃梨的速度像个小孩儿。对了，范叔，你见到我阿爹了吗？
拿下！往前走，别回头，一直走。
回家去。
It's gonna be the aftermath of this. Gonna be nuts.
Fan Xian, you 一生的前途就毁在今朝。
要不我给你道个歉好事吗？
押入地牢。
地牢里伙食怎么样啊？我不爱吃辣，每天有煲汤。
这范公子实在嚣张了些。连出城都懒得等，直接在监察院门口众目睽睽之下搏杀程继树，不知有多少人亲眼得见呢。这是血性少年，看来这个消息啊想瞒都瞒不下来了。
这何止是血性啊，
更多的是审时度势。
这当街杀人毫不遮掩也叫审时度势？
这一杀杀得妙。
I don't know what this emperor just approves of everything that he does.
楚大人留步，
稍等。
So royal decree just came.
您误会了，小人就是吃了雄心豹胆也不敢拦您的路啊。
让开。
等一下，等一下。
Let me catch.
我割你的枝。
Let me catch my breath, nigga.
范大人对庆国有功啊。
疯了不成？
敢问大人，北齐哪位将军提出要用程巨术换他们的军机密报？
这是你该问的事儿吗？
大人请看，
这是什么？
监察院存档，程巨术的生平。
你到底要说什么？
小人都仔细地看过了，程巨树一生孤僻，为人桀骜，不曾在军方有过任何好友。更何况啊，北齐现在的边军所有的将官中大多对他观感不佳，有的甚至是有仇。那么既然如此，怎么会有人提出用他们的军机密报来换程巨树的性命呢？
So you were tricked, you dummy.
就程巨树是假，
送你假情报是真啊。
范大人真是聪慧过人，王某也是这般想的。那对方是想借此机会把假的军机送于我方，一旦开战，那么这些假情报将成为我军的致命陷阱。如此说来，范大人杀了程巨树不但是无过，反而是有功啊。
朱大人，听见没有啊？
朱大人，您就看在范大人这是误打误撞、拨乱反正的份上，您就对他小惩大戒吧。
王启年，为了救范闲，你真是不遗余力啊。
This man really gonna remain ignorant.
我是就事论事啊。
你以为这些东西只有你能看到吗？国运之争何其重要，我能不查清程巨树的底细吗？那我再来问你，我为什么要用程巨树去换那些假情报？你倒说说看。
Nobody knows what the hell you're talking about, bro.
将计就计，让对方误以为我们被骗了。
到时候敌方所设陷阱的一切调动，我方了然于心。破敌只在须臾之间，而范闲杀了程巨树，你说是不是坏我大事？
他毕竟情有可原呐。
监察院何时以情论事了？范闲。你再猜猜看，还有谁会出来救你？
我人缘这么好，猜不着啊。
哼，院长不在京都，没有人能救得了你。
压下去，慢，
且慢。
The Emperor. Is that him? Who is it?
Yan Ruo Hai.
Yan? Who the hell is Yan? Hold on a sec.
这位大叔是谁啊？你不认识？检察院共八处啊，这位是四处主办，监管京城之外的官员，统查密侦探报的严若海严大人。严若海这名字听着耳熟。我儿子因你被贬出京，你是严冰云的爹。
把他放了吧。冰云潜藏于北区国都，生死难料，全是因他所累。我知道，那你还救他？我只是传话。院长不在京都，你传的谁的话？The
Emperor。
陛下密旨。What
did I say? The Emperor, bro.
你打算站着接吗？臣听旨。王大人，这是哪出啊？赶紧跪下吧。跪不了啊，朱大人给我绑上了。王大人，放肆！
算了，我也懒得念了，你自己看吧。意思呢也简单，就是放了范闲。臣接旨。来人，给他送往。I do not know why the emperor keeps saving him.
腰牌还他。
你可以走了，多谢严大人。我儿子的事不提，以你这随性的样子，我是很不喜欢的。就算救你，可我还是瞧不上你，所以不用谢，走吧。哎，王大人，哎，送我一程啊。 小范大人，你偷偷告诉我，你是怎么跟严若海严大人化敌为友的？我都不认识他。那，你认识陛下？你觉得呢？那我就不明白了。你说你在检察院大门口动手杀人，而陛下却下令要放了你，这是为什么？因为我当街杀人。什么什么？我若是暗中杀了程巨树，必定会受到责罚。 反而当街刺杀，却可平安无事。这什么道理？四个字的道理。Four
characters。这便是陛下放人的根由。昨日行刺，京都已经传遍。今日范闲又当众杀了程巨树，所有的人都知道他是在复仇。
那又怎样啊？
程巨树是北齐高手，朱大人，咱们庆国是天下第一强国，百姓向来自傲。如今，咱们庆国的才子杀了北齐的高手，算不算坊间美谈啊？如果我们关了范闲，百姓会怎么想？
You're basically imprisoning a hero. Okay, some logic beyond that.
毕竟是乱了法纪啊，
大战在即，民心可期。陛下要保的不是范闲，而是天下百姓必胜的傲骨，无敌的战意。
Alright.
范闲内心非常清楚，在京都当街刺杀，幕后指使者手眼通天。这只是个开始，未来的路只怕会血海滔天。
阿叔，阿叔，你怎么来了？阿叔，箱子里的大块头怎么样了？你为什么和他打起来了呀？
你在哪儿见过他？
在一个院子里，那时候他还住在箱子里呢。
你还记得在什么地方吗？
记得呀。
告诉阿叔好不好？
在大叔借马厩旁的院子里。阿叔，阿叔，我带你去找我娘。
那人叫程巨树，北齐八品高手，受了伤行动不便，否则我不是对手。我将其格杀，没让孩子瞧见血腥。我杀他是因为昨日午后，子京与我同行，在牛栏街遭遇刺杀。
昨夜点了这盏灯，决定留在京都之后，他跟我说过一番话。
我不愿住在城内，每晚必回归家，记得为我留盏灯。
你不回，灯不灭。
范公子在京都危机四伏，我在他身旁福祸难测，或许有一日这盏灯便等不到我。
范公子他怎样了？
紫荆，
she dying as well? She's sick.
尸首何在？
停在院外。若不是为我，他不会死。我欠子京一条命。
我曾经问他，明知艰险为何留京，他跟我说他一直艰险也想过离去，
只是范公子待我以诚，视我为友，我留下不是为报恩，不是为护主。
To protect my friend.
我却也将你视为知己。你小我些年岁，我便把你当弟弟。既是如此，我又怎能将你一人留在京城，面对人心叵测、明枪暗箭呢？我留下，是我心之所愿。便是刀山火海，生死混淆，我亦不悔。范闲，我把他们托付给你了。
是。Damn.
Fan 公子，这便是他留下的原因。你不欠他的，是他自己选的。
嫂嫂不如和孩子住进京都，从今以后我视他为子侄。
不必了。
我明白，嫂嫂是想留在城外。
You're probably gonna leave.
也好，我让人来照顾，时常探望。
也不用了，往后岁月范公子，我相信你的诚意，只是我不愿他唯一的儿子有朝一日也等不见回城。范公子，他愿为你豁出性命，我一个妇道人家不识大体，心有不甘，难掩怨尤，还请范公子。
I get him. I totally understand where she's coming from. It's like she shouldn't feel any ill will towards him, but at the same time, there's still a certain amount of blame she wants to put on him, and I get that.
便宜天人永隔。嫂嫂就算恨我入骨，也是应当的。那范某告辞了。
我偷偷的看了医处密查的行文，那两个女刺客是东夷城四顾剑的徒子徒孙。
大宗师要杀我？
范大人过虑了，四大宗师那都是超凡脱俗之人，四顾剑一人一剑便守住了东夷城一座城池，那是何等的风姿。
But isn't that person related to C. Lily?
不会用这种鬼祟的行刺，所以说那两个女刺客背后一定是另有主谋的。
会是谁呢？
这就很难猜了，几个剑客都死了，又不知道他们的落脚点，真是一点线索都没有。
我知道他们住处。
你怎么会知道？
你在哪儿见过他？
在一个院子里，那时候他还住在箱子里呢。
你还记得在什么地方吗？
这符号看着眼熟，
你在哪儿见过？
我想想啊，哦对了，监察院潜伏在北齐的密探曾经发布了一份密报，
我扫了一眼，上面有这个符号。
那这符号什么意思？
我没细看它。
那这密报现在在什么地方？
应该在朱大人手里。
诸葛？
对。但是他恐怕不会给你。
我去偷。
哎，还是我去偷吧。啊，这院里边的情况啊，我更熟悉。
这种事儿要是被人抓住，你可曾想过后果？
没有，大人。贩书卖图，这本是违了禁令。我又替您去查了女刺客的身份。干这种事儿啊，我已是经年老手。
我陪你去。
没有，大人，我心领了。其实呢，院里也正在彻查刺杀事件的真相。
你还想跟我说什么？
我今天去查那女刺客身份的时候，行文上有另外一条线索。那女刺客用的弓弩乃是军械。
这你刚才为什么不说？
不，我想这个北齐密探与军方勾结，此事重大，我怕把你牵连进去，惹出麻烦。
那你现在怎么又说了？
方才大人说，连朱大人的密报你都要去偷，那这还在乎什么呀？
既是军械，可曾查到出处？
行文上倒是没写，医处的人应该正在查吧。
那就是还没有眉目。
其实呢，我倒是基本上了解。
说呀。
这个巡城司啊，前一段时间丢了一批弓弩，我想那女刺客用的应该就是这其中的物件。
这事儿你怎么又知道？
检察院
有查检诸军之职啊，那参将呢，前段时间来找我说想把这事情隐瞒过去，我就帮了他。哦，
怪不得没跟院里说。收银子了？
当然要收了，补贴家用嘛。
这种事没少干吧？不然也不会找你。
王某古道中长啊，乐善好义，在这方面是有些好名声。
别跟我扯皮。照你这么说，这参将或许有问题。嗯，
大人，这样，我呢先回院里去偷那密报，看看这东西的由来。大人您去那参将府看看有什么其他的线索。
给我住址。
大人，
有何解释啊？
朱大人，您在院里那是劳苦功高，卑职极为敬仰啊，我这心中的崇敬啊无处发泄，所以再给您打扫房间啊，这一切啊都是肺腑之言呐。
这么说，日间偷查牛栏街行刺一案的行文也是发自肺腑了。
大人都知道了。
拿下，
卑职先走一步。
Yeah, that's how we leave first.
倒是了得，革去王启年文书一职，全城搜捕。
是。
我被朱大人发现了，整个医处的人都在追我。
行行行，别慌别慌，我有提司腰牌，没人能抓你。
这边什么情况？
参将府全府上下悬梁自尽。
全府
？Why？
全府上下一个不留。
这事不对啊！如果说那参将里通敌国，那他的下人们干嘛一起跟他自尽呢？
书房里刚刚还在会客，客人却不见了。
都怨我，如果是我能早将此事告知，也许还能救他们的性命。
你早告知也是一样，对方就是要我晚来一步，而且只晚来一步。
这是警告，也是威胁。
Makes sense. All right, so let's talk about it, man. Episode 14. I really wanted to watch that episode because I really wanted to see what was going to take place. And man, was it an emotional episode. Jesus Christ. So, Xian killed the big dude. Mind you, was revenge. They were trying to get him not to do it. But we know what was going to happen. We know that he was going to go down. I would have been surprised. I actually was surprised that he didn't take the kid as a hostage, to be honest. I really was surprised by that. And then, you know, ended up killing him anyways. So there's this conspiracy going on. And now we're making moves with Wong, right? So it seems like... Even though you guys know how much I don't like Wang, right? You guys should know how much I don't like him. Wang is like the epitome of the type of person you don't want around you. Even though he rocks with you, he would probably sell you out in a second, to be honest. Like, he's too easily bought. In my opinion, he's too easily bought. It's all about the money for him. So I think if they pay him to betray Xian, he probably will. So I still don't really trust him that much. Not putting too much stock into what he has been doing. This time around, they did get caught at the end here at the episode. And this whole situation that's going on, it is not being revealed to us yet on a whole. But I definitely... kind of get the gist of what we are trying to find out about. So one of the things that I've been asking about actually is the situation that's going on with the Emperor. Like, why does he keep protecting Xian? And the thing about it is, I'm wondering if this is a bigger picture thing. That's what I'm wondering, if it's a bigger picture thing or it's just that, you know, he wants him to actually take over the treasury, marry Lin, you know what I mean, to stabilize the country in some way. I'm wondering if that's what it is. So I'm guessing that we're going to, you know, see more of that develop later on. But for now, the way how I want to talk about this episode in regards to Tang Tong, how I don't know how to pronounce it. I think it's Tang, but I want to talk about this a little bit, because sometimes you do things, you know, you see things happen and you're like, why would they make that choice in filming? And a lot of times when it comes down to character deaths, it's also to propel the main character. It's always to propel them into better character development. Where do they go from this? Loss can go in two different directions when it comes on to people experiencing loss. It's either it's going to propel you for greatness or it can keep you very stagnant. And it's all up to the individual to choose that. So it does give you the idea of where Xian is going to end up. Now, he's decided to stay in the city and find out what the hell is going on. Of course, you know, with the situation going on, you know, the Crown Prince, you know, denied, or he refused to say that it's him. Of course, he's not going to own up to it. And of course, Second Prince as well. We know Second Prince is not involved. There is a conspiracy going on in the background that has something to do with someone. We just don't know who exactly it is. Celili is involved in some stuff. She had some dealings with the assassins that went after Xian. Why did they go after Xian? I don't even know. Who hired them to take out Xian, and why are they trying to take him out so bad? Why are they trying to kill him? And the only person that we know that has a serious agenda against them is the Crown Prince. Nobody else is really like going after him like that. It might turn out to be somebody completely different, but at the same time, you know, it's not looking so good right now. As I said, I'm 80% sure that this might be the crown prince behind all of this. It might not be him at all, but right now all fingers are pointing to him, you know. So we'll see how things develop in the upcoming episodes. I like that scene where you know, Lin tried to comfort Xian and help him to understand how, you know, Tang felt about him. And the thing about it is that, of course, you know, if you and a friend go into battle and your friend dies, you're gonna blame yourself. You're going to blame yourself. You know what I'm saying? It's not something you're gonna move on from and be like, oh well, it happened. You know, you're gonna blame yourself because you're gonna say, I should have done more. You know, he died protecting me. Now I feel a little guilty that he had to feel like he had to protect me. I didn't have to make him my bodyguard. I could have forced him to leave. There's a lot of things that run through your head. Love the scene with the wife, the widow now, having to go through her husband's death two times, this time legitimately, is so stressful. And I can understand why she would have some resentment towards Xian. I totally understand where she's coming from and why she explained, you know, he chose to protect you because he felt like you were his little brother. And that's why he couldn't leave, you know, knowing that you're in all sorts of danger all the time, practically, while you're in the city. And that's how close the two of them got. That's how they became, you know, the best of friends. Because if they think of each other like that, look how hurt Xian is because of this. I mean, I don't even think they've known each other for a year. You know what I'm saying? I don't think a year has passed since all of this has been happening. So for them to get that close in such a short time, you know that. And the way how they portrayed it on screen as well was just so well done. I just felt that relationship at the bottom of my heart, man. I felt it. That relationship was so well done in such a short time. The chemistry, the character development between the two of these, the friendship, it was just palpable. You could feel it through the screen. And I really do appreciate them for doing that, because I never... You know, I don't think I shed any tears earlier on in Nirvana and Fire, but this one, it hits home because you know, I have a couple of friends that I know I can depend on like this. I know that I consider, like, to be super close to, and those friends are not easy to find. You know what I'm saying? It's not easy to find. Some people are pretenders. Don't get me wrong. You have people who are your friends, but they're pretend friends, right? They're acquaintances at best, right? So I like the fact that they went as far to do this, and it kind of reminds me of friendship in anime done well. You don't see that much of how anime portrays friendship. You do not see that in TV media a lot. You just don't see it as much. You get what I'm saying? Like, they don't go as far to really write stories that's like that anymore. So it's kind of like, oh, it's whatever, violence. And it's never about the relationship. You know what I'm saying? You might see it in a movie. But TV shows continuously to portray friendship like this in such a short period of time, like literally over the span of like 12 episodes, you don't really see that in mainstream TV shows anymore, to be honest, especially the ones that come out of the United States. You just don't see it. I really do appreciate them for doing that. It really got me, you know what I'm saying? It got me, you know, I can't even deny that. And, you know, just when you think that it was just on a friendship level, you know what I'm saying, they turned it up a notch and turned it into friendship to family. And then when he gets to family, you know what I'm saying? Like, I would have never thought that Tang would have thought of him like that. Like family are needing to protect, you know, a little brother. You know, so that was very well done. So I'm looking forward to seeing, you know, how this is going to go, how this is going to play out. Who are the big players? Who are not the big players? Is this gonna be about the incoming war? Is it that we are trying to stabilize the capital by getting Xian to take over the treasury and to, you know, bring back some sort of peace? I like how they keep referring to the stone tablet outside of the bureau. Like, I like that because I think a lot of this is going to come around back to his mother. But we're going to see how that takes place. In any case, guys, thank you guys so much for tuning in. It was a great episode once again. I'm looking forward to the next ones. Hope you guys are too. I know I'm not. It doesn't look like I'm at the center of the screen, but I promise you, I am. Anyways. Thank you guys so much. I appreciate y'all. And I will catch you guys for the next one. Don't forget to like and comment, man. I'm out. Peace.